This morning I want to talk to you about how to deal with the power of the past. Forgetting what is behind and strain towards what is ahead. Kindly turn your Bibles with me to the book of Philippians chapter 3 verse 13. Philippians chapter 3 verse 13. Maybe I would like to read verse 14 as well. Brothers, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead, I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Paul says so beautifully here, but the one thing that I do, when he mentions the one thing, it simply means to say he has a priority. That's the topmost priority in his life. What is that? Something consciously does, forgetting what is behind and straining towards what is ahead. I want to let you know this morning, your future is in front of you, not behind you. Now, many times we are entangled with the things of the past. We are bound with so many things. By the way, we all want to hold on to our memories. Memories deal with the past. Anywhere we go, what do? We take photos, videos, right? So many things, put it on Facebook. So that we can keep on going back to the past and cherish the memories of the past. Nothing wrong in doing that. But what is really important is forgetting what is behind, however good and bad it is, and being able to focus something which is ahead of you. The Bible says very clearly here, forget what is behind. The Bible doesn't say leave behind what is in the past. I want you to follow me very clearly. The Bible talks about forgetting. Erasing something totally from your memory. Terminating certain things of the past which will not be good enough to you to move towards your future. Those things are going to be a liability in your life. The Bible says forget. Open your mouth and say with me, forget. That's very important. So a lot of people say, I want to forget. It's not that I don't want to forget. I want to forget. But my problem is, I'm not able to forget. That's what I want to focus this morning. The things of the past, the memories, pain, anxiety, all those things really intimidate my soul, my mind, my spirit. I've been struggling with that. I want to forget, but I can't. If you are somebody who says that this morning, I believe the word of the Lord is coming to you so tangibly. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Forgetting is the only way how you can get disconnected from those things of the past which still rule over your mind and your life. There's no other way. I do understand when you say, I cannot. Thank God we can't, but God can. We have the strength of the Holy Spirit. Can I hear an amen? God's going to help you to forget the painful memories of your past, which are no good to you, as He has got something ahead of you. If you're looking back, you can't see what is ahead. Amen? So the Spirit of the Lord says with a prophetic word this morning, you got to gain perspective this morning and be able to understand and perceive something which is ahead of you in the year 2013. And my dear friend, Many people are not able to forget because of unforgiveness and bitterness, grudges. I want to tell you, the devil has a legal right to taunt you with the painful memories of the past as long as you do not release people from your life. You got to forgive everyone in your life, no matter how many years back it took place. It doesn't matter. You got to open your mouth, consciously say, I want to let go of everybody who spoke against me, who hurt me in the past, so that the devil will not find a legitimate hold to put those painful memories in your spirit. I'm going to talk about a young man called Joseph who went through the same, but he overcame the memories, painful memories of the past. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Hallelujah. If you turn your Bible with me to the book of Genesis, fantastic words, as I think we need to really focus on these verses. The book of Genesis, chapter 41, verses 51 and 52. The Bible says, when Joseph had two sons, the Bible says, Joseph named his firstborn Manasseh and said, it is because God has made me forget all my trouble in all my father's household. Can I hear an amen? Amen? Come on, look at me now. Here Joseph so beautifully says, as he went through some of the painful experiences right from his childhood, but he says, it is because God has made me forget. What an amazing thing. Hallelujah. It is God who made me forget. It is because of him. I want to tell you, just like each one of us, he also went through a lot of struggle with the painful memories of the past. But he realized one thing, I cannot do it, but God can. He took the help of the Holy Spirit and he says, it is not me, it is God who made me forget all the things of the past. Can I hear an amen? It is God. It is God. What I want to tell you, my dear friend, God supernaturally with the power of the Holy Spirit can help you deal with the memories of the past. Hallelujah. Whenever I go through some struggle in my life, I ask the Holy Spirit, by your power, Lord, terminate those thoughts out of my mind. Hallelujah. And God helps each one of us. God made me forget. Take the help of the Holy Spirit. Call upon the name of Jesus. God, I don't have strength, but give me your strength through your scriptures that can renew my mind and infuse divine strength in my entire being, in my system, so that I can get rid of some of the things that work like the sting of Satan in my life. So beautifully say, God made me forget all my trouble. And not only that, verse 52 says, the second son, he named him Ephraim and said, it is because God has made me fruitful in the land of my suffering. Open your mouth and say fruitful. Hallelujah. There's a dynamic connection between these two words, forgetting and being fruitful. Forgetting and being fruitful. If you do not forget the things that you should be forgetting, you cannot become productive in your life. Forgetting the things of the past is a must for you to move on into a God-ordained, predestinated future. God has a master plan for you, a blueprint, a master plan. Devil has no power to intercept or destroy the plans that God has for you. Do you believe that? Amen. But the Bible says, you know, there's a great danger where you could be stuck or stagnated, not being able to move on. It's not the fault of God. It's not the fault of the devil. It is your mistake. God says, forget what is behind. Hallelujah. I'm going to make you fruitful. I want you to follow with me. When you listen to the words of Joseph, he says, he made me fruitful. Where? 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 in the land of my suffering. Can I hear an amen? That's a revelation. Hallelujah. Don't tell me God needs special circumstances to bless you. He can bless you anywhere and everywhere. It can be in the pit or in the prison. Hallelujah. It may be in your own land of suffering when you are able to forget the things of the past, leave behind the baggage, and move with the dream that God has given you, with the vision that God has given you. I want to tell you, God can bless you and he will make you fruitful in the land of your suffering. Hallelujah. Probably somebody here who says, yes, I've been going through a lot of pain and suffering in my life. I want to tell you, my dear friend, right in the same place, God's going to bless you. Hold on. Hallelujah. Do not drag the past along with you all the time. I want to tell you, the past is connected to you only in terms of your thought life. Forgetting disconnects you from the power of the past. And you can be fruitful once again. You can be productive once again. What an amazing thing Joseph says. The devil said, this is the land of your suffering. But Joseph says, yes, I know it. But that's where God decided to bless me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So going through suffering is not a bad thing. The Bible says suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope, and hope never disappoints us because God pours out his spirit in our hearts, pours out the love in our hearts through his spirit. Hallelujah. If you go through a path of suffering, I want to tell you, God is molding your character. Pray that God will help you to be released from your past. 2013 is going to be a special year in your life. I'm speaking by the Holy Spirit. It's going to be the year of new beginnings in your life. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do not look back. Do not look back. Move on. The Bible talks about Lot's wife. Lot's wife is somebody who could not forget the things of the past. You know the entire story. When the Lord gave a command to Lot and his wife and children, flee to the mountains because you'll be consumed. So now as they were fleeing, the Bible says, Lot's wife turned back and looked and became a pillar of salt. Listen to me, my dear friend. Looking back into your past is a matter of choice. You don't have to, but you can choose to look back. It is purely your personal choice. Only you are physically moving according to the calendar date, but many of us, we are locked up in the things of the past. We never make progress mentally, spiritually, and emotionally. We are stuck. We are stagnated because, like Lot's wife, you are looking back. You don't have to. Why in the world that Lot's wife would look back? More than life, she decides something else. There was something like a attachment to her soul and mind concerning the things of the past, which she could not get rid out of her mind. Physically, she was running, trying to get out of that area. But then mentally and emotionally, she was bound with the things of Sodom and Gomorrah. I want to tell you, there is something in you that makes you to look back. What is the thing? You're bound with that. Maybe some kind of unwanted desire in your life. The desires of the world, out of which God says, run for your life, but you are there trying to look back because you're bound with certain desires of the world. I want to tell you, whenever the devil is going to put a desire of the world in your heart and mind, it's going to drive you back into the world in order to fulfill the desire. Lot's wife could not get rid out of that. She turned back and became a pillar of salt. Maybe today we may not become a pillar of salt, do we? But we get stagnated. Stagnation. For many years, the enemy can just paralyze you so that you can't make your progress in your life. Memories cause you to look back. You can see what is behind, but with the help of the Holy Spirit, you can perceive what is ahead. Can I hear an amen? Hallelujah. God can give you a supernatural perception into your future. Before the plans of God could become a reality, I want to tell you, God will forecast the vision for your life. Joseph knew it, exactly what he would become. God told, I'm going to lift you up to the extent your dad, your mom, your brothers, sisters, everybody will bow down before you. He kept the dream alive. Listen to me carefully. Those who are dwelling in the past, they hold on to memories. But those who are moving into the future, they hold on to their dreams. Someone said like that, if your memories are stronger than your dreams, then you are living in the past. I want to ask you something. The Holy Spirit gives you a dream so that you can look into the future. Hallelujah. Without the dream from God, your soul is dead. Especially having a dream from God is the most wonderful thing that could happen to any human being on this earth. Hallelujah. God took hold of this young boy of 17 years age and injected within his spirit a dream from heaven. Hallelujah. And I pray this morning some of you will be injected. Hallelujah. With a dream from the heart of the Father. Ignite your spirit. It's going to burn like a fire. You're going to live with that. Hallelujah. Think about the 24-bar sermon. Believing, asking, claiming, standing on the promises of God. Yes, Lord, I believe you've given me a dream. I'm moving towards my future. I refuse to be stuck or stagnated. Hallelujah. Can I hear an amen? Abraham was one. He could leave behind everything and move towards his dream. Some of us, we are not willing to give up some of the things in our lives. We want to hold on to whatever we have, but still expect God to do a miracle. What you give away would basically determine what you're about to get from the Lord. Amen? Dreamers are willing to sacrifice anything for the sake of getting their dream fulfilled. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Hallelujah. They put more value on their dreams than on their memories. Hallelujah. People who are dwelling in the past, they hold on to their memories. Anything that has a special memory for them, they want to hold on to you. To that. Sometimes in our homes, you know, I told my mom there was an old bench. Why not you just get rid of it? No, no, let it be there. We have been having that for the last 30 years. So, memories. No, you remember that house where we were? There only we bought this. We hold on to a lot of things, you know, of the past. We don't want to let that go. Dreamers are willing to sacrifice. Hallelujah. Abraham was one. God put a dream in his heart. I would like to call that as a dreaming with God. Open your mouth and say, dreaming with God. If you're going to dream alone, I want to tell you, it's going to be a daydream. Nothing will happen. The dream that I'm talking about is something that comes from the heart of God before it comes into your heart. It is something that is handed over to you by the Heavenly Father. In fact, it is your Father's dream for your life. Hallelujah. Many times we have our own dream which doesn't tally with the dream of the Father. But God says, I have a dream for you, my son. Take my dream. Hallelujah. Dream along with me. Come, Abraham, I want to take you for a walk. Where, Lord? Let's walk on the seashore. I'm going to show you something. Look at the sands on the seashore. I'm going to bless you like that. Hallelujah. What he was trying to tell him, he was trying to teach him, you can dream. Hallelujah. I will fulfill your promise by my son, my daughter. Dream. Start dreaming. He made him to look into the skies of heaven, all the stars and everything, and told him, look at the stars in the sky, Abraham. I'm going to bless you. And your descendants like the stars in the sky, what he was basically saying to him, dream. Hallelujah. Dream. Those who hold on to the promise of God, they keep their dream alive. Hallelujah. The promise comes by faith. Amen. Hallelujah. Faith is something very essential in order to receive what God has kept in store for you. When you believe the promise, hold on to the promise, speak the promise, stand on the word of God, believing he's not a man to lie, nor a son of man to change his mind. I want to tell you, you would keep your dream alive. Hallelujah. Anything may change. Circumstances may go from the bad to worse, but I want to tell you, but nothing in this world, even for the pit of hell, has the power to destroy the dream that came into your heart from the Father's heart. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm having a father's dream that makes all the difference. It is not the imagination of my mind, vain imagination of my mind. I'm not cooking up something right here in my mind. No. It is something that's given to me by my Father in my spirit. I know it's locked up within my spirit with the signature of God, with the seal of the Holy Spirit, waiting for God's appointed time so that it can come to be fulfilled, not by might nor by power, but by his spirit. Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 11, verses 11 and 12. By faith, Abraham, even though he was past age and Sarah herself was barren, was enabled to become a father because he considered him faithful who had made the promise. I want you to listen to this very carefully. He was enabled. Look at the word, enabled to become a father because he considered him faithful who had made the promise. Listen to me, my dear friend. Hallelujah. He considered him faithful who had made the promise. Hallelujah. The promise is great because of the one who made the promise. Can I hear an amen? He considered him faithful. Dreamers always know and trust in the character of God. Amen? It's not just dreaming all by yourself. You have an authentic and solid foundation. Why you believe and what you believe, how you know your dream is going to come to pass. It's all because I know the one who is faithful. I consider him. Hallelujah. I don't consider my circumstances, my inability, my weaknesses, my failures, my past, but I consider him. Open your mouth and say him. Hallelujah. If that's going to be one reason why my dream would come to pass, because of him who made the promise. Because I consider him as faithful. Hallelujah. And I know that many times I let God down. I have not been faithful to God, but I know he is. He will definitely fulfill what he said he would do. He's a promise keeping God. Hallelujah. Every word that comes out of his mouth is irrevocable. I watch all my word to see to that it is fulfilled, says the Lord. Are you doubting the promise of God in your life? What happened to your dream? What happened to your faith? There was a time you had a dream in your heart. Now your faith is dead. Your dream is dead. You're filled with doubts and fears and questions and anxieties in your life, not really knowing where you're heading. Keep your dream alive. Can I hear an amen? Hallelujah. The Bible talks about Abraham. He considered him faithful who had made the promise. I've got a good news for all of you, my dear friends. The one who made the promise is faithful. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I do not know how and when, how things could happen, but I know, and I know as a dreamer, I have a solid foundation for my faith and for my dream. It is Him who is faithful. Look up to Him. You will not be ashamed. You will not be ashamed. I release this prophetic word right into your spirit in the name of Jesus. My people will not be ashamed even once. Even once. God is fighting the battle on your behalf. Hallelujah. He's zealous about what He promised to you. The Bible says Abraham considered Him. My brother, my sister, consider Him. Consider Him. Don't look at your circumstances. Don't look at the doubts in your mind. Don't look at the past failures and the weaknesses in your life. Don't keep on questioning how it can happen. Don't allow your mind to be ruled with the power of your intellect. God is above your intellectual knowledge. Can I hear an amen? He's above everything. He calls things that are not as though they were. He gives life to the dead. That's the power of God. When He speaks, things will come into existence. The word of the promise that you receive from God, it's a creative power. God will bring into existence. Even if it doesn't exist now, you don't have to see in order to believe. Hallelujah. I'm talking to somebody. You don't have to see in order to believe. Are you with me? Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, no mind has ever conceived what God has kept in store for me. But I know, and I know my Redeemer lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How do I know? I've got a dream alive in my spirit. Hallelujah. The devil will do his best to destroy the dream in your life. You want to tell you God is a liar? Forget about the dream. Joseph, your dream and your circumstances don't tally. You are right now in the pit. Joseph, your situation is going from the bad to worse. Now you are in prison. Joseph, your dream has nothing to do with your life. It is just the empty imagination of your own thinking. I want to tell you how Joseph could have really understood that the dream that he had was from God. I was trying to find some evidence. He could not go to church or a synagogue or a worship. He was in a foreign land as a slave, as a prisoner. Nobody there to counsel, no pastor, no rabbi, nothing. All alone, led by himself. But the Bible says God was with him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He knew the dream that he had from God is real. It's all because the one who made the dream, the one who gave the dream, was with him all the time. God was with him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to let you know this morning, it's a powerful revelation. Listen to me. Follow what I'm trying to say. You have a dream and you have a question how it will come to pass. The presence of God in your life is the clear evidence that God is going to do something about your dream. Amen. You can feel His presence now. You can feel His glory. Hallelujah. You're not left alone. Not only He gave you the dream, but He happens to be with you all the time. Think about Abraham. God said, take your one and only son and go to one of the mountains I will show you about, and there sacrifice him. I told you, dreamers are willing to sacrifice anything. Some of you are not willing to sacrifice anything in your life. Your dream cannot come to pass. Every dream has a cost. Are you with me? It's okay to dream with God, but at the same time, you must be willing to pay the price. Hallelujah. If you put more value on the dream, then you'd be willing to give away anything that you have. The Bible says that God told Abraham, go take your one and only son, Isaac, and make him a burnt offering to me. Listen carefully. If you look into Hebrews, it says very clearly there, verse 17, by faith, Abraham, and when God tested him, offered Isaac as a sacrifice. God tested him. Open your mouth and say, tested him. Dreamers are tested. Dreamers are tested. God tested Abraham. The Bible says, he who had received the promise was about to sacrifice his one and only son, even though God had said to him, it is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned. Verse 19, Abraham reasoned that God could raise the dead, and figuratively speaking, he did receive Isaac back from death. My goodness, I don't understand something here according to human logic. God told, give your one and only son. But God made a promise saying, it was through Isaac, I'm going to bless you. So now, Abraham taking Isaac and laying him on the altar to be given as a burnt offering, you know something? He believed God made the promise. Even though I have to slay my son, but still God will resurrect him. Hallelujah. According to the Bible, I want to tell you, there's something you need to understand. Yes, I'm willing to sacrifice, but I'm looking for another miracle along with my sacrifice. That is nothing but the resurrection of my son. Hallelujah. Isaac is my future. He believed God could raise him from the dead. So the Bible tells me, I want to tell you, he was looking forward to see something happening. Even if my son dies, but I know I'm ready to witness the resurrection. God's going to raise him from the dead. Hallelujah. God could raise him from the dead. Dreamers have unusual faith. Hallelujah. If you have an unusual vision and dream from God, I want to tell you, you must have an unusual faith in your life. Abraham reasoned. What kind of reasoning? Not an intellectual reasoning. Never. Never, never, never. That reasoning has nothing to do with his mind. The reasoning has to do with the revelation in his spirit. I want to tell you, spirit has a different calculation than what your mind does. Amen? And many of us, we are getting deceived because we happen to listen to our own mind. To your own soul. We don't allow your spirit to really guide you. Those who are being led by the Spirit of God are called sons of God. Amen. Do not lean on your own understanding. But acknowledge him in all your ways. I want to tell you, God has a divine reasoning right in your spirit, which is not based upon human mental intellectual assumptions and calculations, but it's based upon the divine revelation God has birthed in your spirit. Hallelujah. That's what Job knew, and he didn't know what was happening, but he knew something. And I know, and I know, and I know, and I know my Redeemer lives. Paul said, I know in whom I believe. Hallelujah. Don't try to be looking for answers in your mind. It's a waste of time. I don't mean to say you commit an intellectual suicide. No, never. What I'm trying to say, the reasoning you have in your spirit is much higher than the reasoning you have in your mind. Amen? Don't try to confine God within your five senses. God is much bigger than that. Don't be like a doubting Thomas. Unless I see, I won't believe. You will never believe, and you also will never see. Look into the invisible. Believe the incredible. You will receive the impossible. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm moving on in a different dimension altogether. My dear friend, keep your dreams alive in the name of Jesus. Never ever take the vision that God has given you so lightly. Some of you have forgotten your dream. Some of you are thinking about your good old days. When you talk to some people, they always talk about, Pastor, do you know, 10 years back, I was full of fire of the Holy Ghost. 5 years back, God did this miracle. Oh, 15 years back, I did that. I said, I'm tired of listening all day. What God is doing through your life today? Somebody listening? I know you're hearing sounds. Are you listening? Hello, are you with me? Don't talk about your good old days, what God did through you. Oh, the good old days. You're still living in the past. God has got something much bigger for you in the future. Why can't you see what God is doing in your life today? What God has for you 1 year from now, 2 years from now, 5 years from now, 10 years from now. Oh, I want to tell you, Psalmist prayed to God saying, Lord, teach me to number my days right. Hallelujah. Oh, my dear friend, the Bible says all the days which have been ordained for you and me, it's written in this book, even before one of them came to be. Hallelujah. Every step is ordered by God. Hallelujah. Dreamers always feel secure in the presence of God. Joseph felt very secure. Prison could not give him security, but the presence of God did. Can I hear an amen? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You might have been in the pit or in the prison, but you would have told, I always feel secured. My dream is still alive. Hallelujah. You can take away from me my dad, my mom, my money, everything. My land, everything is gone except one thing. What is that? The dream. Hallelujah. Pit could not destroy the dream. Prison could not take away the dream. The dream was alive. It was becoming bigger and bigger until one day it became a big, huge reality which affected the entire world, because the Bible says that nations around the world, they came to Joseph in Egypt to buy grain. Hallelujah. Are you with me? Are you listening to what I'm saying? I want you to know something. It's a powerful revelation that struck me yesterday. Don't measure the success of your life based upon your circumstances. You may look around, it may be a pit. You may be thrown into a prison. But that doesn't measure the success of your life. Joseph said something fantastically. He told his brothers, God sent me ahead of you. In other words, he was trying to say, guys, you know something? You might have put me in the prison or in the pit or sold me as a slave, but I'm always ahead of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! I'm always ahead of you. Come on, put your hands together. Give the glory to God. Hallelujah. People may trouble you, backbite against you, pull you down, but let the whole world know you are ahead of them. Amen. Amen. Because the presence of God is with me. God was with Joseph. It's only a matter of time before he could become the prime minister. Dreamers are always ahead of other people. Amen. They don't see themselves as the victim of somebody else's jealousy or hatred, because they believe in the sovereignty of God. Dreamers always trust in the sovereignty of God. Open your mouth and say, sovereignty of God. What do you mean? All ruling, overpowering. Everything is in the control of the Almighty God. Amen. Don't give up. Don't allow the things of the past to destroy your future. The Lord says, forget The word is coming to some of you so tangibly this morning. Forget, my son, forget. Oh, my daughter, forget, forget, forget. You got to be disconnected from the things of the past. Forgetting is the only way. You cannot do it by your own strength, but I'm going to make you to forget. Just like Joseph said, God made me forget. You know, people can live with some of the very intimidating thoughts of the past till they go to the grave. The Holy Spirit alone can give you the power to deal with the power of the past. The vicious tentacles of the past may not strangulate your life, suffocate your life. I'm speaking by the Spirit of God this morning. You got to be free in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When you walk out of this door, some of the things in your life must be terminated, discarded, burned by the fire of the Holy Spirit. And God's going to help many of you to forget some of the things of the past. You have a brand new future. Amen. Hallelujah. I'll listen to the testimony of some of the worst sinners of the world. Now they are the best vessels in the hands of the Almighty God. Hallelujah. The worst can become best. Hallelujah. The weak can become strong in a sense. Hallelujah. Those who are from the prison can rise up to the palace. God has a roadmap for your life. Do you believe? How will I get out of this situation? Where I will go? I want to tell you, God has a roadmap. Why do you cry? There is an invisible ladder that God has already put for you right in the prison, and nobody else knew about that. Hallelujah. And I also want to tell you, sometime in your worst circumstances, your best potential comes out. It's realized. Can I hear an amen? Hallelujah. He began to operate in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Word, not in the church, not in the synagogue, but in the prison. Hallelujah. In the prison. Amen. And that's what ultimately lifted him up to the palace. Listen to me, my dear friend. Dreamers, listen to me. What you do in prison will be unlocked before the kings one day. Keep doing what God has called you to do. That's what I spoke about, understanding your divine assignment. In times of trouble, Joseph knew for sure, I'm in the prison according to God's plan. What I'm supposed to do here, interpret dreams for somebody. Oh, I have my own dream. But at the same time, I do not know when it will come to pass. I know it will come to pass, but I do not know when. But now God tells him, I know you have a dream, but now it's time for you to interpret somebody else's dream. Hallelujah. That's what exactly he did. Anything you do out of the power of the Holy Spirit, it may be something like hidden in a prison door, within a prison doors, between you and maybe few people. But I want to tell you, God will bring that to the light. Hallelujah. Forget your past. Don't assume things, please. You need God to forget the things of the past. It's not something like you do something, then you go home and just take a bath and you think everything is clean. I wish it could be like that. It doesn't work out that way. There's only one thing that can break the power of the past. It is nothing but the power of the Holy Spirit through His blood and through His word. Can I hear an amen? You need God. Joseph said, God made me forget. You're going to say out of your own mouth the things that you could not forget in the past. You will say, God made me forget. Hallelujah. God enabling you to forget. Hallelujah. Literally taking away those intimidating, painful memories out of your system, out of your mind. Take it away and go into the pits of hell in the name of Jesus. That is the power of God. Hallelujah. Don't look back. Look towards what is ahead. I want to prophesy over you. There is something ahead of you. Don't cry over the things of the past. I want to look into your eyes and speak that in the name of Jesus. Listen, listen. There is something ahead of you. Nobody can tell you that except God. The people who love you the most in this world, they cannot tell you that. Joseph's dad didn't know, mom didn't know, brothers, nobody didn't know what God alone could tell him. There was a secret between him and God. Joseph, I got a dream. I got a secret concerning your life. Nobody knew about that. Even your own dad and mom, they have no idea about this dream. But I want to unlock this dream from my heart into your heart. There are only certain things that God alone can talk about your life. There is something ahead of you. It is ready. Amen. You got to just keep moving. Take a step of faith. Leave behind your memories. Start dreaming. Hallelujah. Start believing. Start claiming. Forgetting what is behind and strain towards what is ahead. I'm moving on. I refuse to be stagnated. I'm moving on. Not by my own strength, but by his strength. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Oh my soul, worship his holy name. Hallelujah. You know why Joseph could forgive everybody? Tell me. They were jealous of him. All those things. Only thing is they want to murder, but they could not murder him. That's it. But he could forgive all of them. You know why? Dreamers know for sure they are ahead of everybody. Why I should be angry on you? I'm ahead of you. Hallelujah. People who hurt you, tell them, I'm not angry with you. I'm ahead of you. Amen. Tell everybody who's trying to victimize you, tell them, I am ahead of you. God's keeping me ahead of all of you. Then why I should be angry? In fact, I want to love. In fact, I want to give. In fact, I want to bless. Because I'm ahead of you. Hallelujah. God sent me ahead of you. This is a prophetic word. I inject that right into your spirit. God is sending some of you ahead of many of your own friends and relatives and families. Hallelujah. It may be a painful path of suffering, but I want to tell you, God is sending you ahead of many other people so that you can be a blessing. Stand with me, my dear friend. Hallelujah.
The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Lift your hands and say, bless the Lord. And my my time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forever. Worship your holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name.
Dear friends, if you have a dream, your perspective will be different. Amen. Don't see yourself as a victim. Joseph never looked at himself as a victim, but he looked at himself saying, I'm head of many other people. Amen. You are ahead of many other people. I'm ahead. I'm going forward. I'm not a victim of the past. All the things of the past, I'm moving on. I have a dream. I want to keep my dream alive by standing upon the promises of God, by speaking the word of faith. Hallelujah.
If you this morning lift your hand, if you truly decide to be disconnected from the things of the past, ask the Lord for the divine strength to make you to forget certain things. You cannot do it by your own strength, but the Holy Spirit can help you. Just like Joseph, you can say, it is because God who made me forget all the troubles of my past. It is because God who made me forget. I want you to say that out of your mouth. God will make me forget. Open your mouth and say, God will make me forget. Hallelujah. There is a divine interception by the mighty hand of God between the things of your past and you right now. God stands in between both of these things and looking at your past, he commands the past, never pursue my son, my daughter, like a shadow. I disconnect you today in the most powerful name of Jesus from the entangles of the past. God commands the past right now on your behalf. Lift your hand and begin to pray, everybody, as I pray for you. Come on, come on. Something is about to happen in your spirit right now as you walk out of this church. And I believe some of the things in your own life, in your own memories, will be terminated, will be consumed by the fire, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Pray along with me. Father God, I pray for everybody who pray along with me. I pray even for those who are listening to the word through the television, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Every power of the past, the sting of Satan, I break it right now in Jesus' name. The God who made Joseph to forget the things of the past, troubles of the past, will help your children to forget the things of the past, to be disconnected from the things of the past and move on into the future that God alone has kept in store for them. Hallelujah. I prophesy over your people. They are ahead of many people. Hallelujah. They're ahead of many people who speak against them. Oh, the malignant name who trouble them. Oh, but you keep them ahead of everybody. Ahead of everybody. I prophesy that in the name of Jesus, God's people will be ahead of everyone else. Dreams will come to pass. Hallelujah. Father's dream will come to pass. Lord, you have a dream for my brother, for my sister who are praying right now. Your dream for their life will come to pass. Maybe their dream could not come to pass, but your dream for their lives will come to pass in the name of Jesus. I bless them, Lord. Bless them, Lord. We give you glory and honor. In Jesus' most powerful name we pray.
Jesus, what a beautiful name. Truth revealed, my future sealed, healed my pain. Love and freedom, life and warmth, grace that blows all fear away. Jesus, what a beautiful name. Jesus, what a beautiful name. Rescued my soul, my stronghold, lifts me from shame. Forgiveness, security.